What's the team's mindset after that loss on Wednesday?
Just go out and compete. I mean, you lose games in the NBA, so nothing different than before. Just go out and play hard.
When Atlanta's kind of targeting you down a stretch there and switches, is that a tough thing to kind of deal with?
No, I mean, I'm a rookie, so you expect it. It's just another learning experience for me, so just take it as it is and just learn from it.
What were your biggest takeaways kind of watching that film back?
Just be better on the ball. I mean, it's crunch time, so Trae Young draws a lot of fouls late, so just know who you're guarding and at what time.
How much are you learning this season? It seems like every week, every 10 days is like a new stretch for you that, you know, new things are coming up, but you got to learn and grow.
Yeah, I mean, not every game's not every game's the same. So, I mean, there's different things offensively and defensively that I have to pick up if I want to stay on the court. So, I mean, all the coaches work with me and things like that on different things. So that's kind of what I've been tuned in for.
How aware are you of this upcoming stretch against, you know, I don't know how many it is, but teams with a losing record? I think the next seven games are against teams under 500. How aware are you of that fact?
I mean, it doesn't matter. Every team's an NBA team. There's only 450 guys in the league, so these are the best players in the world, so you can't take any team lightly going into this stretch.
What's the key for you guys to clean up, maybe live ball turnovers?
I'd just say is defensively just getting better overall. I mean, we miss a lot of layups, a lot of transition things, and things like that. So defensively, just get back, keep the ball in front of us, and I think we'll be good.
Are you noticing any kind of, maybe along those lines, some bad habits kind of bubbling up over this past week or so that really need to be addressed?
I don't think there's bad habits. I just think that there's things, especially in transition, that we need to work on. I mean, it's different game to game, so just trying to figure out and be consistent with what we're working on in practice.
You guys have a winning record on your home floor, but I would imagine it's not what you guys would want ideally. What is there, like a mindset thing, or is there a certain focus that you guys need to have to be better on your home floor?
I mean, it's just closing out games. I mean, every game we're in is close, so it's just trying to get that last run and push the game forward. Just try and close out teams early. I think that's our biggest thing, especially at home. So we definitely need to work on that a little more.
How much are you learning from those tight games?
I mean, every situation is different. Up four the other night, we're down in Utah. So just figuring out, especially, I mean, we have Fox on the court on the offensive end. So that takes care of itself, but defensively just getting stops.
Earlier in that Atlanta game, it felt like you made a handful of good plays, kind of rotating over as the low man. Like, do you feel like you've made a lot of progress in that aspect throughout the course of this year?
Yeah, I mean, I made a lot of progress defensively, just looking back on my first couple of games. And I think, obviously, Coach Brown challenged me, and I've accepted that challenge. So I'm just trying to get better on both sides of the ball.
You had twice Lakers in the preseason. You've gone up against them several times. What do you just make of that team and, obviously, the experience of going up against somebody like LeBron?
Yeah, they're a good team. I know they're missing a couple guys. So they're a team that can win against any team any night. So they just have to be ready going into tomorrow.
Do you feel like you've had like a welcome to the NBA moment so far?
I mean, not really. I mean, you're playing against really good guys every single night. So that's what that is. And I mean, the travel's kind of tough at first, but I mean, I've gotten used to that. So I mean, I don't know. I probably already had it, just didn't realize it. So.
West Rookie of the Month, how meaningful was that for you? Was that a goal you've had going into the season, or is it something that you're just kind of taking in stride?
I mean, it wasn't a goal going into the season. It was just, I mean, it's something I'm grateful for, obviously. Not many guys are able to accomplish that. So it's a cool accolade, but I mean, we have end goals as a team, and that's what I'm more focused on.